बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम अल्लाहुम्मा रब्बी ज़िदनी इल्मा सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम आमीन। सर्कल्स लेक्चर 3 बी काइंड विद एवरीवन। एग्जांपल्स इन दिस लेक्चर आई विल सॉल्व फ्यू इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग द सर्कल्स। नंबर 1, फाइंड द इक्वेशन ऑफ द सर्कल दैट हैज़ ए बी एज अ डायमीटर। नाउ दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट सिंस ए बी इज़ अ डायमीटर, देयरफॉर the midpoint of AB, which is the C point C right now here, the midpoint of AB will be the center of the circle. So C is the midpoint of AB. Well, first get the midpoint of AB. This is the midpoint of line AB. So by finding the midpoint of AB, we can easily find the center of the circle. After finding the center of the circle, we can easily get the radius by taking the distance, by finding the distance CA. We have options, we can either find CA or CB. So I'm finding CA. So this is the radius, but since I have to substitute R square, therefore I have squared this R. So I have R square is 8. Now substitute center, the coordinate of center here and here. Be careful regarding this minus 2 sign. When you will substitute this, make sure you substitute correctly, like it should be plus 2, and R square was 8. So this is the required equation of the circle, this one. Question number 2, a circle passes through the points O, P and Q. Find the equation of the circle. Since this circle passes through 3 points O, P and Q, so you have to make 2 chords. Number 1, make any 2 chords, like chord OP, chord OQ, chord PQ. You have options, you can make any 2 from these 3. I have made OP and PQ. OP is here and PQ is here. So you have option, you can either make OQ. So after making these 2 chords, you need to draw their perpendicular bisectors. I mean, you have to draw the bisector of chord OP and then chord PQ. This is the perpendicular bisector of chord OP. This one, and then draw the perpendicular bisector of chord PQ. This is the perpendicular bisector of chord PQ. Now center is the point of intersection of these 2 bisectors. Why? Because center always lie on the perpendicular bisector of the chord. Therefore, in order to get the center, we need to find the equation of these 2 bisectors here. I have found the equation of both the bisectors. For the bisector of OP, we need to first get the midpoint of OP. This is the midpoint of OP, and this is the gradient of OP, and this is the gradient of the perpendicular bisector. Now work for the bisector PQ. So this is the midpoint of PQ, this is the gradient of PQ, and this is the gradient of the perpendicular bisector of PQ. This is the working of the equation of perpendicular bisector OP, and here this is the final equation of the bisector OP, and this is the equation of the bisector PQ. Now by solving these 2 equations simultaneously, we can easily get these center, and this is the center of the circle. For radius, you have options. You have 3 options. You can either find this distance OC, or you can find distance CQ, or you can even find distance CP. So you can find any distance. I work for CO, and I have found CO, OC or CO, the same thing. So for radius, I found OC, and that's the radius. Now for the equation of circle, substitute everything into standard equation of circle. So here is the final equation of the circle which passes through the points A, B and C or PQ, OP and Q. In fact, OP and Q. This is the concept of this question. When three points lie on the circumference of a circle, then draw any two perpendicular bisectors of the chords like chord OP, chord OQ or chord PQ. You can make any two perpendicular bisectors. I made bisectors of these two chords in the example question. And solve the equations of the bisectors to get the center. Now this is question number 3. Find the equation of the circle that passes through the point A and B and has its center lying on the point line. Now this, there are two conditions. The circle passes through these two points and the center of the circle lies on this line. First you need to draw the you need to make the rough sketch. This is the rough sketch of this situation. Well, here the point A is, and this is the point B, and this line is here. This is the line equation of the given line and the equation. Well, you know, the center lies on the bisector of this chord AB. I mean, center always lie on the bisector of the chord. So this is the perpendicular bisector of this chord AB. In order to get the center, and see, center is the point of intersection of this red line, which is the perpendicular bisector of AB, and this purple line, which is the given. So in order to get C, we need to work for the equation of perpendicular bisector of AB. So first get the equation of the perpendicular bisector of AB and then solve that equation with this given equation for the center. I have explained this here as well. The center is the point of intersection of the perpendicular bisector AB and the line 2x plus y. So this is the midpoint of AB, and this is the gradient of AB, and this is the gradient of the perpendicular bisector of AB, and here is the final equation of the perpendicular bisector of AB. Now call this equation as number 2, and this is the equation number 1. Now for center, we have to solve these two equations simultaneously. So by solving 1 and 2, we get C 5 and minus 3. This is the center of the circle. For radius, you can either work for CA or CB. You have option. I use CB. So here is the radius. After getting center and radius, substitute everything into the original equation of circle. So this is the final equation of the circle. Question number 4. The points P and Q lie on the circumference of a circle. Show that the center of the circle lies on the line 4x plus 2y 15. In this question, they are basically saying that the center lies on the perpendicular bisector of chord PQ. You know, center all lies on the bisector of the chord. So in other words, this statement means that you need to show that the equation of CM is this line, this 4x plus 2y 15. Because center always lie on the perpendicular bisector, therefore this is the equation of this line. So the examiner is basically saying, show that the equation of CM is this. So this is the concept of this question. We basically need to show the equation of this line. The equation of CM must be exactly like this. So equation of CM. First get the midpoint of PQ and then get the gradient of the perpendicular line, bisector, and now substitute everything into y minus y1 mx minus x1. Here is the final equation, and which is exactly same as this equation, given equation. Hence, center lies on this line. This is the question number 5. Find the equation of the circle that touch the x-axis. A circle which touch the x-axis. Touch the x-axis means the x-axis is tangent to the circle. This statement means x-axis is a tangent to the circle. Touch the x-axis means x-axis is a tangent. Now this is the rough sketch of the circle. Since the y-coordinate the center is negative, because of this negative, minus 5 means the circle is below the x-axis. I mean, you could also sketch this question like this, but you cannot do this because the y-coordinate of center is negative. Since the y-coordinate of the center is negative, this minus 5 means the circle is below the x-axis, and it must be in the fourth quadrant because x-coordinate is positive. So this is 6 minus 5. So this intercept is minus 5, whereas this x-intercept is 6. Hence, you can easily get this point. This is 6 comma 0. If you need this point, this is 6 comma 0. If you need this point, this is 0 minus 5. Anyway, we don't need 0 minus 5. Well, we have the center. It's given. And this is the radius. This is the radius, which is 5 units. This length is 5 units. So we have radius, we have the center, we can easily get the equation of the circle. Here is the center, this is the radius, and this is the final equation of the circle. This chapter is over. Good luck. I hope you all, if you will watch all 3 lectures, then you will be good at this chapter. Be good with everyone, and good luck. Allah Hafiz.